Hey guys, it's Jill here from Lavender and Friends, your source of essential oil education and inspiration. As I was saying, tonight we're going to be doing a live talking about oils and anxiety. Now, this is a topic I get asked a lot about, and I do have a bit of personal experience. So I wanted to, I guess, take some time to sit down and go with you guys about how we can be using our oils to help support us in a natural way. Now, please make sure that you stay tuned to the end because I do have some special little gifts in store for you. And as always, if you're active and participate and you comment and engage, there will be giveaway prizes. Another little warning as well before we kick off, both of my kids are having trouble getting to sleep tonight, so I may get distracted. We may end up with some kids in this webinar, but we'll see how we go. So, tonight we're going to be chatting about essential oils and anxiety. So for those of you that are watching, I'd love if you could say hello and just kick off by letting me know if you're watching it live, whereabouts you're watching it from. So maybe you're in Australia, maybe you're overseas, maybe you're on the Central Coast like me. I'd love just to find out a bit more about where you guys are watching from. Hi, Michelle. Hi, Kelly. Thank you guys so much for joining us. Now, with anxiety, I just want to start by sharing a bit about my personal experience because that's what I can speak from. I can only speak from what I know. So I had postnatal depression when my first daughter was born. It was a really rough time, not gonna lie. It was probably the darkest times in my life. And I was very blessed to have people around me who loved me and supported me through that time. Fortunately, I have recovered from that and I don't have it any longer. And I'm obviously very blessed with a second baby. But the residual effects of that is that I do get a bit of anxiety. Now, those that know me know I'm a very bubbly, a very happy, very enthusiastic type person. But even I sometimes can struggle with just these really crippling, frozen thoughts of just terrible things happening. And I know that anxiety appears in different ways and impacts people in different ways in different scenarios. But for me, I often find I just get the runaway train of negative thought is the easiest way to explain it. Now, my husband also actually has an anxiety disorder as well. And so that was quite an interesting experience as well, being the partner of someone who does suffer from anxiety. So maybe you're watching this today because you don't have anxiety, but you love someone who does or know someone who does. And I hope that you find this webinar really helpful as well. Now, what we'll be doing tonight is we'll be chatting about what anxiety is. I'll run you through some information about essential oils, how to use them, just make sure you know kind of what you're doing. And then we'll look at some of the things we can be using our oils for and how we can use them. So just saying hi to Kira, hi Nicole. Michelle's watching it live in Narara, feeding her beautiful baby. Lewis is saying hello. Kelly is watching from Portland, Victoria. And hi, Corinne. Thanks, guys, for joining. Okay, so what is anxiety? What does anxiety actually mean? Now, prior to getting married, I'll be honest, I didn't really know much about anxiety, so it's definitely been something I've had to learn about. And from the Australian Psychology Society, this is the definition. Anxiety is a natural and usually short-lived reaction to a stressful situation associated with feelings of worry, nervousness, or apprehension. It typically occurs in new or unfamiliar or challenging situations where a person might not feel up to the task or where the outcome is uncertain. For people with anxiety disorders, however, thoughts, feelings, or physical symptoms are severe, upsetting, frequent, and can interrupt daily life. Now, common symptoms of anxiety include difficulty concentrating, restlessness, a rapid heartbeat, trembling, shaking, feeling lightheaded or faint, numbness, nausea, sweating, and avoidance. Now, do any of you guys experience those? Is this something that you guys can relate to? If maybe any of those, I guess, symptoms are something you understand, I'd love if you could pop in the comments and let me know and let me see. Nicole says anxiety is the worst. Getting there, glad to hear that's getting better. Sleeping and winding down when it hits is the hardest. Evelyn, hi, and Melissa, and hi to Natalie. Now, what I want to do actually is I want to actually look at what does anxiety actually look like in real life. So we've got the definition we've read out, and I'm actually going to get my husband to come and join me. So I'd like to introduce you to my wonderful husband. This is Will Ford.
Hello.
So this is my husband, and he has been, I guess, oiled up not so willingly at the start, but now a bit more willingly. And we're actually going to have a bit of chat, and he's going to share a bit of his experiences about anxiety because it's something he deals with on a regular basis. So I guess to start with, how did you first find out that you have an anxiety problem?
So very, very, very early on in my life when I was a little kid, I sort of just didn't react to social situations the same way as most of the other kids did. I was very sort of socially reclusive and stuff like that. And I had a lot of separation anxiety when I was little. So I'd cry every morning when my mum dropped me off at school until about year 12. So, you know, it's very, very obvious early on that I had a lot of issues with anxiety and that sort of thing. And for me, I mean, for everybody, anxiety manifests itself very differently. And I think it's important to acknowledge that, as you did at the start of the video, you know, what anxiety looks like for me, what it looks like for Jill, are two different things. And luckily for us, we can sort of support each other through that because we recognize it in each other, which is really good. But it's going to be a little bit different for everybody. So again, this is just sort of my experience with my own journey. But for me, it was sort of the feeling that I was out of control in general, but more so the feeling that things that should be easy, things that everyday people, you know, will take for granted, were a real struggle for me. So, and that manifested itself in ways like, you know, when we went away on a family holiday a couple of years ago, now around the world trip, I was absolutely shitting myself about flying. One of my triggers is flying. I can't stand flying.
In my defense, I didn't actually realize how bad anxiety can be. And when he said he was afraid of flying, I was like, oh, cool, he'll just be a bit nervous.
She wasn't expecting to have to look after a baby, basically. I was a quivering mess. But basically what it meant was that even though I was excited about going away on holiday, I was so nervous that it took the enjoyment out of it. So, you know, I'd be working myself up into an absolute frenzy about getting on the next plane, and, you know, it just zapped the enjoyment out of it. And that's what life for me, before I managed to take control of the anxiety back for myself, looked like. Basically, I was never really able to enjoy anything because I was always nervous about something. And I'm a big believer that you've got 100% of yourself and your energy to give to whatever it is that you're doing. So, you know, if 80% of that energy is being taken up by the anxiety that you feel in day-to-day life, then you're only left with 20% of yourself to give to everything else, which kind of sucks. And I mean, that's, you know, that's your own enjoyment. It's also the energy that you give to relationships as well. So, you know, if I'm spending 80% of my time being worried about something, then it only leaves 20% that I can give to, you know, loving my family and supporting my family and stuff like that. So it really, you know, it's much more than just feeling scared. It's much more than just, I don't feel comfortable with the situation. It really does affect every single area of your life, from relationships to work. I mean, I used to be terrified of taking certain jobs that I won't take because I don't want to have to travel. I used to work for Sony Electronics, and I got offered a position within the company to do product specializing with a line of products, and I didn't take it simply because I didn't want to have to be flying around Australia all the time because I knew that I couldn't cope with it. So
and like Michelle said as well, panic about the panic, like you're worried about the fear.
Yeah, and I think one of the things just along those lines as well is that people don't realize is that, you know, your brain does control all the other areas of your body, whether it's consciously or subconsciously. So the symptoms that you get, and for me with anxiety, the typical symptoms that I get are sort of the knots in my stomach, the diarrhea, you know, that kind of thing. So, and those symptoms are real. And a lot of the time they go, oh, it's just in your head. It's just in your head. But I mean, it's not, it's a real symptom. What's causing it is kind of irrelevant, really. Yeah. And you know, if I've got diarrhea and I can't go to work, it doesn't matter whether it's in my head or not. It's still,
it's still in the toilet.
Exactly. So for me, the first step was really realizing that I did have a problem and seeking help. And thankfully for me, my mother was a really great support in this regard. She took me to see a psychologist pretty early on. I think when I was around 14 years old when I started taking medication for anxiety. And I was on that medication for about 8 years initially, and then I went off it for a little while and went back on it again a little bit later on. But the most important thing for me was developing strategies to actually recognize what was an irrational fear and what was a rational fear. And then, you know, not being afraid to tell people when I was feeling scared, because, you know, I'd be the guy at the party sitting in the corner that couldn't handle, you know, all the noise and everything, and just being completely overloaded. And everybody else is just thinking, oh, you know, what's wrong with this guy?
Why is he so antisocial?
Yeah, why am I being so antisocial? And, you know, if I just said to my friends, hey, I'm really struggling, they would have helped me, but I never had the guts to do that until later on. But recognizing what my triggers were and then taking steps to really, you know, have a deeper understanding of my own, you know, mental state. And then that's the first step to sort of taking the control back. So For me, taking the sort of, you know, medications like Arapax and SSRIs, they've got a lot of side effects. They do work, but, you know, I put on a lot of weight, and then obviously there was a depression from having the weight gain and things like that. Another big side effect of those medications as well is reduced libido as well. So your sex drive goes down the toilet, which kind of sucks. So I'm trying to stay away from that. But, you know, it's just like, for me, I didn't like taking those medications because I kind of lost track of who I was. I was like, you know, is me the person that I am when I'm on the medication? Is me the person that I am when I'm not taking the medication? You know, and how can people love me? How can people get to know me, or, you know, understand me if me is a different person depending on where I'm at and what I'm doing? And that's the thing, is like, it can flip-flop so quickly. Like, you can be perfectly fine and then you're thrown into a situation that you can't handle, and suddenly you just become this completely different person. So
I found as well, so when I had postnatal depression, I was on an SSRI as well for a few months, and I found that it took the edge off and it was what I needed. But the thing I found is the lows weren't as low, but the highs weren't as high. You were just kind of flat all the time. And look, if that's what you need, then that's what you need. And I have no shame about taking the medication, and I would never tell anyone not to take their medication.
Definitely, yeah.
But I think for me, I wanted something that was a more natural alternative. And I think, like you said, there can be that, I guess, that feeling of well, if who I'm not, who am I? Am I the person I'm on a medication? Yeah. Am I the person I'm not? And that can be quite scary. And also, you know, there are, like you said, there are side effects to these medications.
I think that also people fall into the trap of thinking, and we were just talking about this the other day with the kids and how we've been in and out of doctors recently. And, you know, kids think that when you're sick, you go to the doctor and the doctor fixes it, right?
Mm.
And a lot of times we think of, you know, essential oils or medication as things that will just fix a problem.
Mm.
And a lot of people think, oh, if you've got anxiety, you just go on medication and it will fix it. And that's really, at least for me, that wasn't the case. What it did was it took the edge off enough for me to realize the difference between an irrational and a rational fear. So when I was starting to slip into a state where I was having an irrational fear, I was able to go, hang on, no, you're okay, you've got this, and then control it from there, right? So it wasn't just making me not an anxious person anymore.
Yes.
But it was allowing me to have that control back. And also, as well, in addition to going on medication as well, I saw a psychologist various different psychologists for years, probably almost a decade. And I learned, like, I got to the point now where I don't really even go to psychologists anymore because I kind of know what they're going to say. And
you do it to me when I'm stressing
out. I do it
out.
To you as well. I'm very good at sort of helping my friends
what
get
through.
What
are you doing? What
are
you talking about?
Yeah, what's going
about?
On here? But it's made me a really analytical person. I can really sort of, you know, cut through to the core issue of what's going on for people, which is great. But yeah, so understanding what my triggers were and really, you know, taking the control back from those triggers so I can go, all right, I've got this situation coming up. I know that I'm going to feel a certain way about it. What can I do to take the control back? So, you know, is it something that I can do? So say, for example, flying, which is one of my biggest fears, I went and watched every single episode of Air Crash Investigation, which to most people would sound insane. Why would you watch a TV show about plane crashes to
where
make
you're
yourself
scared of flying? This
yeah,
is what
it
I'm
seems
saying.
Completely stupid. But for me, because I'm a very logical person, understanding what causes an accident and then understanding what steps have been taken to stop it happening again helps me. And when I'm in a situation on a plane where the captain comes out of the cabin and he goes and looks down the hatch, I know what he's doing, and therefore it's not as scary to me. So, but that's, you know, that's what works for me. So it's really about understanding how it is that your brain reacts to situations and then going, all right, well, how can I work with that? How can I take the control back so that when I'm in a situation that I know I'm not going to be able to deal with, I can take steps to, you know, to take the control back. And medication, meditation, you know, seeing psychologists, they're all just sort of tools that we use to help ourselves control our own emotions.
And looking at some of the comments, a lot of you guys are agreeing things like, you know, worrying about the panic, feeling trouble sleeping, having the medication be a band-aid to help you get back on your feet, and the over-analyzing, just that constant not being able to switch the brain off.
Yeah.
And now I guess, do you want to share a little bit now about what you do to support your anxiety at the moment?
Yeah. So look, I've actually, to be perfectly honest with everybody, I've actually been considering going back on medication lately just because we've been dealing with a lot of stressful stuff with kids not sleeping and stuff like that. And generally, as I was saying before, because I've got a lot of experience with psychologists and taking medication and stuff like that, I know what my limits are, and I know when I'm reaching the point where I need some additional help. But yeah, the biggest things for me, in addition to the medication that I've been taking on and off for a long time, has just been not being afraid to tell people how I'm feeling, especially in the workplace. And that's been a massive one for me, is that, you know, you kind of feel like it's your own problem and that people won't understand. And just because people don't necessarily understand doesn't mean that they're not compassionate. And, you know, they do care. And, you know, you can't be an efficient worker if you're not being honest about how you're feeling. And, you know, people can't help you if they don't know.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, that goes for work, that goes for relationships, whether it's romantic relationships or just friendships or whatever. You know, if you're open about how you're feeling and you're open about your struggles, people will help you and they'll generally rally around you. So that's one thing, being open about how you're feeling, but also, you know, not being ashamed of who you are as well. Like, I guess embracing it. And one of the things that I'm really proud of for myself is that in a lot of ways I've been able to actually turn it into a positive thing for me. Like, I've been able to use my experience to help other people.
Especially me.
Help you, yeah. And, you know, to me, you know, if what I've been through in my life I can use to help other people, then it's kind of worth it. So I think that it's made me a much more sensitive person, for one. But yeah, like, I guess it's like anything in life. If you can, there's always a positive to be taken from every scenario. You're just going to kind of be open to it. And for me, just sort of, you know, realizing that, being honest about myself, being honest to myself about how I'm feeling as well, and not being ashamed of it. You know, like, if I start to feel anxious, you know, I don't need to feel like I'm being silly, because all I really need to do is just accept that that's who I am, and then go, all right, what do I need to do to take control of this? Is this a rational fear? No. Okay. Well, what can I do to help myself feel less anxious? And, you know, it's not about fixing the anxiety for me. Like, I'm always going to be an anxious person. I'm always going to be scared to get on a plane. I'm always going to be scared of, you know, being outside my comfort zone. But putting those checks and balances in place to sort of, you know, allow people to support me through whatever means when I am in that state and understand what it is that I'm going through is a really important factor. And I think the most powerful thing that we can do. And I feel like, you know, I've started to use essential oils for this stuff now, and Jill's going to talk a little bit more about that later on. But in my mind, it really is sort of, you know, it's not a case of take the essential oils and the problem's going to go away. It's taking the essential oils for me takes the edge off enough that I can sort of recognize when I've got a problem, and, you know, take the appropriate steps to work around it without, you know, flipping off the edge.
Yeah. And look, one thing that I am very clear on, and we both completely agree with, is that if you do need professional help, there is nothing wrong with that. Yeah. Like, the analogy I always say is, if you break your arm, you get a cast on it and you go see a doctor. If you're having a mental health issue, go see a psychologist. If you need something to help you get you through that period, then take it, use it, use these tools. I mean, for me, and in our family and in our life, we consider this oil box to be our toolbox, and it's one of many, many tools.
Yeah.
Meditation, yoga, going for a walk, these are all things we can use. Obviously, I'm going to focus on the oils today, and I'm going to chat with you about the oils, but I just want you to know that there is nothing, like, mental health is nothing to be ashamed of. And that's one of the reasons I talk about it, is because I have been there and it sucks, but because I had so many friends supporting me and loving me, it really helped me to get through that. And so maybe if you are having, you know, anxiety, things like that, like Will said, reaching out and talking to your friends can actually really, really help you with that.
Especially now with social media and the way things are, people are generally a lot more open about stuff to complete strangers anyway. Yeah. And I think the culture around this kind of thing, mental health issues, is really starting to change, especially in the last couple of years. It's a lot more normal to be abnormal these days. Like, it's okay to talk about your feelings now.
Yes.
Whereas before it was very much, oh no, we don't go there.
And especially for guys, like, I know
massively.
That's probably a big thing for you as well. And I know, like, when we first started dating, I often have to explain to my friends, like, he's not being antisocial. He gets overwhelmed. Yeah. And then, like, for example, a coping mechanism we use he brings a camera when we go to parties. So if he's getting overwhelmed, he can just pop behind the camera lens and take pictures, literally hide behind the camera. But it means that if he's getting too bothered, I'll just go, babe, go get your camera and take some pictures. And fortunately, he's really good at taking photos. But it's about having a support person too. So for example, he can see when I'm starting to get triggered by something, I can see when he's starting to get triggered, and I can go take your frankincense, you know, so that's kind of helpful too. Now disclaimer, this is the official disclaimer. I'm not a doctor. I cannot treat, diagnose, prevent or cure anything. Obviously if you are on any kind of medication or, you know, have need professional help, please do talk to a trusted health practitioner and obviously, work with them as well. Now what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to quickly run through some information about essential oils, and then we're going to chat about how we can use these oils to support us. Now for a more detailed overview of using essential oils, in the Lavender and Friends Oil Squad, which is the Facebook group, you will find some intro to oils videos. Just look them up or look in the videos tab, and I've done a full online class so you can watch that. So this is just going to be a really quick overview for those of you that maybe aren't as confident with your oil use yet.
Do you want to just answer that question from Michelle quickly too? Sure. Michelle asked, do you find it easy to wean on and off? I assume you're talking about SSRI medication there. Correct me if I'm wrong. Look, yes and no, and it's going to be very different for everybody here. Obviously, everybody's body works differently. For me, when I originally started taking the medication, I was 14 years old, and originally it did make me feel quite sick. I got pretty nasty headaches as well from it. Now the way SSRI medication works is it's actually changing the chemical balances inside your brain, and that's how it actually changes your mental state. So it's not a medication like, you know, Valium or something where you go, oh, I'm feeling anxious, pop a pill and it goes away, and then it wears off after a couple of hours and you're back to normal. It's a balanced thing. So you need to have a constant level inside your brain, and if that level starts to drop, then you start to have side effects, just like, you know, coming off any sort of medication like that. So for me, I ended up being on quite a low dosage because I was using it as a supplement along with all the other tools that I developed through the study and, you know, the psychologists and stuff. I was able to take a very, very, very low dosage, which meant that if I knew that I had a stressful situation coming up in about a week's time, I could take my pills. And then once that situation was over, I could kind of wean myself back off again. So I was kind of on and off. Now, doctors don't recommend that you do it that way, but that's the way I ended up doing it after, you know, 6 years of taking the medication prior to that. But yeah, a lot of people will find that, coming off the medication is a really, really big deal. You get nasty headaches, you get a lot of fluctuations emotionally as well. So you don't know where you are. You kind of lose track of yourself a little bit as well. And that's honestly, that's been the reason why I've been reluctant to go back on medication again a couple of times when I felt like maybe I should. Because being able to use other tools, you know, just like my relaxation techniques and the oils and stuff, I find is enough for me now that I don't need the other medication unless things get really bad. So hopefully that answers that question.
And I was going to say, another point along with that is one of the challenges that people often have is they start taking medication and then they think, oh, I'm fine, I don't need this medication anymore, and then they stop.
Yeah, no.
And that's not cool.
Yeah.
So for me as well, when I was put on the medication, I worked very closely with a psychologist who basically checked up on me every couple of weeks. And then when the time came for me to go off them, I think she was checking with me every like 2 or 3 days. She'd just give me a ring, check how I was going, see how things were, because coming on or off them suddenly can
Another point there, talk to a doctor.
Yeah.
Another important point there as well is that your own perception of how you react to scenarios can be distorted as well. Yeah. So if you might think that you're fine, but then like I might think that I'm totally fine. Oh no, I'm cool, I'm all good.
And I'm like,
and then you go and ask her and she's like, oh wow, no, he's not coping at all. And that can be the same with a lot of other disorders like bipolar and stuff like that as well. So it's really important to also, you know, I really recommend if you're seeing a psychologist, also get a loved one or somebody that's very close to you involved as well, so they can offer a third party perspective on how you're coping day to day as well. Obviously, it's not going to be possible for everybody. But I remember probably 10 years ago now, I actually worked with a guy who had bipolar disorder. And we talked quite a lot about this stuff because I suffered with anxiety, which was one of the things that he had a problem with as well. And I remember him telling me about how he thought he was coping, and he was having a lot of problems finding the right level of medication that worked for him. And I actually ended up going with him to see his psychologist, or psychiatrist it was actually. And just through having my feedback, they were able to find the right concoction for him within a couple of months, and he was right as rain.
Yeah.
Simply because, you know, your own perception of the way you react isn't always how other people, or how it actually is in real life. So
yeah.
Especially when you're taking a substance that alters the way the chemical balances are inside your brain, you know, reality can be quite distorted. So
Like Christy said, perception is key. So that's a good thing to share. Now, so we're going to quickly jump into an overview of oils. So what are oils? Essential oils are volatile aromatic compounds, which is a fancy way of saying they basically are extracted from plants, and they are extracted, so they're distilled in some way, and we can use them to support our body through a variety of emotional and physical methods. Now, essential oils aren't a common thing, not a common thing, they aren't a modern thing. They've been used for centuries throughout history. Even back in the Bible, there's countless Bible references to using essential oils. However, with the modern technologies we have now, it's much easier to source and create pure essential oils, and also to test the oils and then distribute them, which is, I guess, part of the reason why there's been such an influx. Now, I'd love it if you guys could type in the comments that are watching, why do you think essential oils are becoming more popular? Why do you think these sort of natural solutions are getting more popular? I'd love to hear from you, I guess, why you think that they're getting more popular. So with essential oils, basically the way they work is they have chemicals inside them which can then impact upon our brain and the way that our body functions. So this is a very brief overview, and I'll warn you guys now, I'm a trained early childhood teacher, so when I explain science, I generally explain it at the level of 3 to 5 year olds. So it might seem a bit amateur and juvenile, but this is just how I do it. Basically, when you open a bottle of oil and you smell it, or you inhale the smell, what happens is, or if you put it on your skin, however it is that those oils get inside your body, what happens is those chemicals that are inside that oil go up into your brain, and they start talking to your brain and telling your brain, let's do this, let's do that. So in the case of, for example, say we're inhaling our lavender, which is a really beautiful calming oil. We smell it in, and what happens is the chemicals go up our brain, which is, they go up to our olfactory bulb, which is basically our smell center in our brain. Then our olfactory bulb talks to our limbic center, and they go, meh, 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 meh. And our limbic center is basically what controls our emotions. So the olfactory bulb goes, hey, we've got some lavender, time to calm everything down. And then our limbic center goes, okay, and tells our heart rate to start lowering. It tells our brain to start relaxing. It tells our lungs to start taking nice deep breaths. And so that lavender is then going to basically help our body to calm down and enter that relaxed state. Put in comparison to something like, say, our peppermint. So our peppermint's going to pep us up. So as we smell that peppermint, our olfactory bulb is going to go, hey, limbic center, it's time for some peppermint. And sorry, I'm used to explaining this to kids. And the peppermint's going to basically get our heart rate going. It's going to get us nice and awake. It's going to get our brain alert and focused. And that's how these oils can then impact our body. So obviously, the way that we're feeling emotionally, or the way that that anxiety is manifesting itself, we can then use our oils as a support. So for some people, when they have anxiety, they get really flighty. They get stuck in their head. They just, you know, they feel really kind of out of control. And so having the grounding oils, they're going to help to draw them in and calm them down. That's what's going to really, really help them. For other people, having anxiety might mean they just get paralyzed with fear, and they can't do anything, and they don't know what to do, and they get really flat or really depressed. And in which case, having some uplifting oils, having something that's going to motivate them and get them going, is what's going to really support them. So it's going to kind of, it is quite individual, and it also,
it can change from day to day as well. Like, I mean, I have some days where I wake up and I'm just like, yeah, let's go, let's do this. Even though I know that it's going to be a stressful situation. You know, I feel invigorated and, you know, charged to just do it. And then I'll have other days where I think everybody's probably experienced this, even people that don't suffer from anxiety necessarily, is you wake up and you're just like, you know what? I can't do this today.
I can't adult today.
And you literally can't get out of bed. It's like you're sick. You just got no energy. You feel completely flat. So the oils that you might use in that situation will be completely different to what you might use, even though the the actual trigger is the same.
Yes. And that's why that's the thing. These are tools. It's not a one-size-fits-all approach. I mean, I have oils that I recommend to pretty much everyone because they are amazing oils. But at the same time, day-to-day, it's about being intuitive and listening to what your body is needing and what you need. Now, why do I use doTERRA oils? And this is something I'm really, really going to stress because I think it's quite important. doTERRA oils are 100% pure. So when they get their oils, each batch is actually independently tested by a third party. It's called the Aromatic Research Center. Find them on Facebook. If you love science, they're amazing to follow. And actually on the bottom of every single batch of oil, there is actually a batch code. And you can go to the Source to You website, www.sourcetoyou.com. And you can actually type it in and you can find the results for that exact batch. Now they're testing for purity and also for potency. So firstly, they test to make sure there's no additives, no fillers, nothing in that bottle except for the essential oil. And the second thing they test for is potency. So they make sure that it has the correct chemical constituents to actually do what it needs to do. Another reason I love doTERRA is they do use indigenous plants, which means they're sourcing the oils where Mother Nature intended it to. And they actually travel the world to find the best plant material to make the best oil. They use co-impact sourcing, which means they work with the local farmers. They don't get their oil from a middleman or a broker. And the work they do through their Healing Hands Foundation, which is their charitable foundation, is just amazing stuff. And I really encourage you to take time to watch that intro video. If you go into the Oil Squad, there is an intro to oils video. And I go into this in a lot more detail, so I do recommend having a look at it. Now, how do we use our oils? I'm going to quickly skim through this. There's three ways we use our oils: aromatically, topically, and internally. So internally means we actually take the oils inside of our body. That could mean simply adding a drop to our water and drinking it. It could mean using in our food to add flavoring to our food. Or there's even things like, this is called a veggie cap. It's a little clear pill, and you basically pop the lid off, put the oils in, and take it internally. Now, with taking oils internally, you do always need to read the label to make sure it is safe to be taken internally. And please do not ingest oils that are not doTERRA. I cannot comment on their standards. With the doTERRA oils, I do know that they're pure, and so I don't mind taking them internally. And with that as well, use your discretion. If you don't want to take them internally, that's fine. You can still use the oils in other methods. Second way we can use our oils is topically. That means to apply it on our skin. Now, when we're using our oils topically, we do want to use a carrier oil. The carrier oil is going to help to carry that essential into the skin, so it's not just going to evaporate off. And it's also going to help protect your skin against any skin sensitivity. These oils are really, really potent, and so we want to be using them safely. I really recommend using fractionated coconut oil. Fractionated coconut oil is odorless. It's non-greasy and it's liquid at room temperature. It could be as simple as literally putting your hand out, drop of fractionated coconut oil, drop of your lavender, rub it together and just massage it on your neck. Another way we can be using oils topically is with rollers. These are called rollers. They have a roller ball on top, so you can just literally rub it up and down. The beauty of these is you can mix up any combination you like, and you can just carry them around in your handbag ready to go. So I actually have a roller made up of Balance that I actually, and I'll talk more about that oil later, that I carry around in my handbag. So anytime if we're out and I can see any of the kids are acting up or we're feeling a bit anxious, we can just apply it straight away. Now, doTERRA does make their own rollers. They're called the Touch Range. So if it says touch on the label, it means that it's actually been diluted with a carrier oil, which is fractionated coconut oil, and then it's safe to just take the lid off and apply it straight away. The third way that we can be using our essential oils is aromatically, which means to just inhale the scent. That could be as simple as putting a drop on your hands, rubbing it together and breathing it in. Or it could mean wearing a diffuser jewelry. So this is actually a diffuser bracelet. So what you do is you can actually open up the lid like that. And there's a green, you can see there's a little green pad in there. So I'll just try to take out for a second. It's a bit clunky. So there's a little pad. Pop the oil on that, pop it in, and then all throughout my day, I can just smell it and see how I'm going. I also have diffuser necklaces, which I sell, and you can see them on my website. And for those of you that are joining in and participating, obviously you'll have a chance at winning something like that tonight. The other way we can use our oils aromatically is using a diffuser. So this is our beautiful petal diffuser. As you can see, it's got some steam shooting up into the air. It's a cool mist, so it's not going to fog up your house. It's pretty simple. 1, 2, and 4 hours. You fill it up with water, add 4 to 6 drops of oil, and then you turn it on. When it runs out of time or it runs out of water, it's going to switch off automatically. And it's just cool water, so it's not a burn risk or a damage like that. And this is a great way you can be using any combination of oils. Now, I'm just going to read out some of the reasons you guys have commented that you guys believe people are turning to natural solutions. So Heidi's saying that people are more concerned about the impact we have on the environment and ourselves. Nicole is saying, thanks for going live. Mental health needs to be spoken about. And Nicole, that's one of the reasons I wanted to do this. It is something that we should be talking about. Kira is saying, we're looking for as many tools as possible in the toolbox. And that's exactly what we're saying today. This is a really fabulous tool you can use along with other things. Melissa's commenting how people can often medicate very quickly. And it's true. Doctors, you know, we love doctors, but the fact is they don't necessarily, in the 10 minutes they have with you, they might not necessarily have the time to sit there and unravel the many different factors going on in your life. And so sometimes it is easier just to say, here, take this pill rather than...
A lot of the time as well, their job is to give you a quick fix.
Yeah. Exactly.
You know, like that, you, especially these days. I mean, like, I remember when I was younger, you could make an appointment with your family doctor the next day, whereas these days, for, you know, for anything like that, you're going to go to a medical center. You're probably going to see a doctor you've never seen before, yep, knows nothing about you. And yeah, I mean, their job is to fix as many people as quickly as possible. So they're going to say, all right, yeah. And I mean, one really good thing is that they do have, at least in New South Wales now, I don't know about elsewhere, but there's a free government subsidized mental health plan that you can go on to. And yep. So as part of the process of going on to SSRI medication, they actually put you into a mental health program and you get, I think it's 4 or 5 free sessions with a psychologist as well. Mm. So there are some really great programs in place, but at the same time, there is still that, you know, as part of the whole process of it becoming more normal and more accepted to talk about these kinds of problems, it's also becoming more normal for people to be on medication.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh yeah, I'm on medication. Yeah, me too. It's kind of like, you know, in the 90s, it was asthma. Everybody had asthma. And then in the late 90s, it was everybody had ADHD, you know, and I was diagnosed with both of those things, you know. So, it's just one of those things. It doesn't mean that it's not true. Mm. You know, I'm not saying that the doctors are wrong. I'm just saying that, you know, the ability to take control for yourself and make the changes in your life that will help you the most is much more important than just, you know, jumping straight to a medication as a quick fix.
Yep. Exactly.
Yeah.
And Aaron says people are sick and tired of being told to pop a pill and things go away. And that's true. Pretty the much, medication yeah. doesn't, you know, sometimes it has side effects. Sometimes it doesn't work exactly the way we thought it would. So again, this is a tool we can be using to help support ourselves. And Bianca says anything holistic is better than chemicals. So, and oils are natural and safe from Natasha. So exactly, these are the reasons we started looking at oils as well. These are all the reasons that we wanted to be proactive about our health, and especially with young children, we wanted to be having a solution that is a bit safer and a bit gentler. Now, which oils, let's get to the good bit, which oils are good for anxiety? Now, again, like I said before, it depends on what you're wanting to feel, how your anxiety manifests, how that day-to-day need you have. And one of the things I will mention as well, which I forgot to grab that oil here, so I can't hold it up. One of the symptoms a lot of people get with anxiety is that upset tummy, that, you know, the nervous diarrhea, or, you know, that vomity feeling.
Even IBS.
So I used to do elite gymnastics and I used to throw up before every competition pretty much. It was horrific. So I get the whole anxiety making you physically feel sick. It manifests itself. So one oil that I will recommend is called Digest Zen. It is a digestive blend and it's amazing for giving you support to that digestive system. It's a blend of all the different oils that are really good at soothing any sort of stomach issues. Mm. So if you're wanting to kind of, I guess, alleviate that tension, quickest and easiest way that I recommend is just put a couple of drops on your tummy, on your hand with some carrier oil and massage that into your tummy. And that's a really, really,
it's a really good one from a practical point of view as well, because I mean, a lot of people, it sounds funny, but you know, like, as I said before, a lot of people might get an upset tummy before a job interview or something like that, for example. And then they're like, oh my God, what if I have to go to the toilet during the interview?
And then that anxiety.
And so then they're more anxious because they think they might have to go. And I used to call it toilet anxiety. You know, so, and that was one of the big reasons why I had so many problems with school, was because I was scared that everybody teased me for having to go to the toilet in the middle of a class.
Mm.
But the reason I need to go to the toilet is because I was anxious.
Yeah.
Because I might need to go to
the toilet.
So having something practical like Digest Zen that actually takes that edge off in a physical sense is a massive help.
Yeah. Now, one thing I will say is that many essential oils are actually really high in a chemical constituent called linalool. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, but we'll go with linalool. Now, that's really well known for their ability to reduce stress and anxious feelings. Now, good old lavender, which we love, is actually incredibly high in linalool, and it can actually help to deal with those anxious feelings you're experiencing. It can help to cut out that stress and also be promoting relaxation. So it's a beautiful oil to be using when you're feeling anxious and you feel like you want to be calmed and grounded. Now, fun fact, which I found out recently, is that coriander is also almost as high as lavender in linalool, and so it can actually be used for peace and calming. I didn't know that, but there you go. And if you want to learn a bit more about coriander, I actually do have a video I did a couple weeks ago about coriander versus cilantro. So just jump in and watch that, and you can learn all about this beautiful little oil. Now, another oil that I'll share is frankincense. Now, frankincense is known as the king of the oils, and it's actually been shown to reduce heart rate, balance your blood pressure, helps to, you know, soothe anxiety, helps to boost your mood. And whether it's inhaled or it's diffused, it can actually create a feeling of peace, the relaxation, the satisfaction, and just that overall emotional and spiritual wellness. Now, this is one that I actually take a drop under my tongue most mornings. We put it in my daughter's diffuser because it helps keep her calm, and this is the one that I've been making. I'm like force feeding him.
Well, to begin with, take some of this, because it doesn't really taste that great, to be honest.
When you first take it, I'll be totally honest, it's not the best flavor, but it is definitely a good one.
Yeah.
Now, for those of you that are watching, I'd love it if you could pop in the comments what oils you guys like using for when you want to feel calmed and grounded. So I'm going to go through some of my favorites. If you could pop in the comments which ones you like. And if you see that someone else has commented an oil that you like, just say me too, or comment on their comment, and, you know, let's have a bit of a chat about some oils we're all using at this time. Okay, so frankincense. Frankincense, king of the oils, a really great one. I have to say, if I could only pick one oil for calming, it would be a really close toll between frankincense and balance, because I think for me, and maybe lavender, I think probably these two would be my top two picks in terms of keeping everything calm.
For me, the frankincense is the one that takes the edge off the actual emotion of anxiety.
Mm.
And then I combine that with the oil that's most suitable for the actual physical situation that I'm in.
Yep.
So if I'm anxious because I've got a shitload of stuff I need to get done today,
yep,
and I don't know how I'm going to do it, then I'll take frankincense with something that's going to make me energized.
Peppermint.
Whereas if I'm in a situation where I have to get on a plane or something like that, I'll take something that's actually going to calm me and relax me and, you know, do all that sort of stuff in addition to the frankincense.
Yep.
So it's about, you know, it's not about this oil is going to fix this problem. It's more about, okay, what's the actual situation I'm facing and what combination is going to best suit that scenario?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much exactly what he said. Then we've got balance. So balance is the grounding blend, and this is the one that I find personally the most helpful for me. For me, my anxiety tends to appear as just the runaway thought train, where I'll just get this bad thought in my head and just I can't seem to break that negative, something bad's going to happen thought pattern. And so I find a drop of this on the bottom of my feet every morning. It's what I wear in my diffuser jewelry. And then even throughout the day, if I'm feeling stressed, I'll put my little roller on the side of my neck. I'll put a drop on my hands and just take a deep breath. And it's just one that I sort of take a deep breath, and then I'll do usually three deep breaths. So again, it's about that mentally calming myself, getting that oxygen in. And often I'll do some sort of an affirmation, because I'm trying to break that negative thought chain by thinking about something else. Now, another one that's a really popular one is Neroli Touch. So it actually comes as a roller like this. Now, Neroli Touch is actually derived from the flowers of the orange tree. And there's actually been a lot of research conducted about the aroma of neroli oil and how it's really calming and uplifting. And it can instill relaxation and also promote that spiritual and emotional well-being. So it's a really good one for calming yourself down. And that's a fairly new oil in Australia, and it's one that's just a beautiful one. Now, just a couple of your comments. Barbara, how do you apply Frankie exactly under the tongue? Literally, I go, like that.
One or two drops, yeah. Not.
A little tip as well, you can buy online these droppers. That's a little dropper thing. They're usually about $2 online, and then you could literally just take it and do a drop that way. I find that a bit easier. I found that when I do it from the bottle, I always get two drops instead of just one. So that's another tip I would have.
Just don't knock over the bottle if you've got a dropper, because it doesn't there's have no anything lid. To stop it from spilling.
And Michelle, I only do just one drop under the tongue for me personally, sometimes two. Now, Haley's mentioned she loves lavender and the new yoga oils. Amanda loves lavender as well. Balance and Elevation, Lavender Peace, which is awesome.
That's my favorite.
Yep, he loves the lavender. Balance for Kira. Yep, another vote for Balance. Now, Kelly's got the mood management on the wish list for next month. That's awesome. And Amanda uses the droppers too. So we've actually mentioned this one as well, which is our Lavender Peace. So Lavender Peace is the restful blend. Do you want to tell them about it? Because it's your fave.
Well, it basically has all the same properties as lavender, but it smells a little less abrasive. I find the smell of lavender is a little bit too abrasive for me. Some people love it, some people hate it.
Mm.
This one's got a much more sort of, I guess, calming scent to it in addition to the actual physical effects of it. So it's a bit easier to sleep with. It doesn't kind of make you go, you know.
Lavender.
Yeah. Whoa, lavender. You know? So
lavender is a bit of a polarizing smell, whereas I find this one's a bit more chilled out. So it's got things in it like vetiver, which is a really great calming oil. It's got hoewood, cedarwood, all those woody oils to help sort of calm you down. And another one I'll mention too is peace, which is the reassuring blend. Now, you guys have probably heard a few times about my love-hate relationship with peace. If you haven't, then just read a few of my posts. But I find for me, I only like the smell of peace when I need it. So if I'm feeling stressed, love the smell, can't get enough. When I'm feeling happy, think it smells revolting. So if maybe you have peace and you haven't been a huge fan or haven't been super impressed by it, it might just be that you don't actually need it right now.
It's probably a topic for another video in more detail, but I find talking to people a lot, they actually find after a while of using the oils, they do actually, their body starts to tell them what they need.
Yes.
And it sounds a little bit crazy, but, you know, we all sort of say, oh, I feel like I need my coffee.
Yes.
It's the same as that. Yep. You know, I feel like I need my lavender. I feel like I need my frankincense. You know, your body does start to crave what it needs.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, definitely. And I think that's a good video we can do another time, because that's something I get asked a lot. Well, how do you know what to use? You just kind of know. Now, another one I'm going to mention is the Easy Air. So Easy Air is the respiratory blend, which might seem like a bit of a weird one to be talking about for anxiety, because this one usually comes up when I'm talking about colds and flus. But when you are stressed, I read this one quote that I loved, and it was, the difference between fear and exhilaration is breathing. When you're stressed, when you're afraid, you hold your breath and you tense up and you get really stressed. When you're excited and you're enjoying something, you're like, yeah, this is awesome. And so the reason I mention that is when you're stressed out and you have trouble breathing, you get that stressed out state. Easy Air is a beautiful oil that you can rub on your chest, and it just helps you to relax. It helps you to breathe in, get that oxygen going. And that's going to really help if you are feeling really tense or anxious about something. So Easy Air is more than just a cold and flu type of oil. It's a really great one to be using for when you're having that feeling of tension and, you know, stiffness. It can really help you to open up and get a bit more joyful. And another one, the final one I'll mention in terms of calming oils that I love is the vetiver. Now, vetiver is an amazing oil. It literally, I'm just going to hold it up so you can see this.
It's like syrup.
It's like a syrup. Yeah. Like, that's how slow it goes. Honey. It's like honey. So if you have and you don't have a dropper, prepare to spend about 3 minutes just waiting for it to come down. Stick it down your bra. It warms it up. The heat makes it go faster. But this is probably one of the, I guess, one of the most potent ones for grounding and calming. And to use it, I recommend, and what I would do is just massaging it into your feet. It's a really, really great way to be using it. Now, Michelle has asked, can you remind the drops versus coconut oil mix for rollers? So, So when we're doing our rollers, first of all, use your reference book. So the Modern Essentials reference book is great, and it guides you in terms of how much you need to dilute. As a general rule, you'd be doing at least one drop of fractionated coconut oil to one drop of essential oil. But again, it depends on the oil. Some oils are hot oils, like oregano is a hot oil. For more details, if you watch that video about the intro to oils, I'll go through that in more detail. But For example, generally when I make my rollers in a 5 mil roller, I do between 10 and 20 drops of essential oil and then fill the rest with carrier oil. I then test it out. If I think it's not strong enough or it's not quite working, I will increase the amount of essential oil, bearing in mind not to go over 50% essential oil to fractionated coconut oil, because we do want to have that carrier oil in there. And for some oils, it's even going to be less. So definitely have a chat to your enroller about dilution, or look at your Modern Essentials book would be my suggestion for that. And Natalie says she agrees with my easier comment, which I'm very glad to hear. It's one that I find quite useful as well. Okay, so let's flip it now and let's look at if we want to feel uplifted, if we want to feel optimistic and happy, and maybe we need a bit of a, you know, kick in the pants to get us out of that frozen, paralyzed fear moment. So the first one I'm going to mention, which is probably, along with frankincense and balance, this is my third oil that I would always be recommending, and that's beautiful wild orange. So who here loves wild orange? Give me a little love heart if you love wild orange as much as I do, or if you've used it. I'd love if you could pop in the comments how you use your wild orange, because it is one of the more versatile oils. So wild orange is actually cold pressed from the peel, and it's actually one of the top selling doTERRA oils because it's really energizing in terms of its aroma, and it's actually got a lot of different benefits. So it's actually really high in monoterpenes, so it actually is both stimulating and uplifting, and it's a great one to be diffusing. You can also take it daily in your drinking water for a citrus burst of flavor, which I will definitely agree with. It tastes amazing, and you can use it as a natural surface cleaner too. Now, when you're diffusing it, it will actually energize and uplift you physically and emotionally. Emotionally as well, it's also good at stopping the brain chatter. So for me, when I find I get that runaway thought train and I just can't seem to break it, a drop of wild orange in my hands, a couple of deep breaths, and again, using it with my balance and wild orange is a combo I absolutely love in terms of just the balance ground. It sounds strange, I know, but the balance grounds me and helps me to stay calm. And then that wild orange lifts me up and gets me joyful and gets me back in that positive state of mind. I love this oil because it's such an easy smell. It's such a beautiful smell, and it's so easy to use. I will make a safety note. Citrus oils, most citrus oils are photosensitive. So if you apply it on your skin, you need to avoid direct sunlight for around 12 hours. Some oils a little bit longer. Again, look at your reference books for more guidance on that. Now, Haley, diffuser in the water. Kelly puts it in the diffuser. Natasha puts in the palm of her hands.
Paul's question as well.
Scroll up. Yep. It's okay to take
is
with.
Is it okay?
Paul asks, are these oils okay to take with SSRIs? I would suggest discussing with your doctor if you are on any kind of medication.
Yeah.
Because as I said at the start, I'm not a doctor and I can't make that call. That said, I do know people who use the oils in conjunction with their medication, and they can be, it's another tool.
Yeah, so basically to answer that directly, SSRI stands for selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor. So what it's basically doing inside your brain is it's stabilizing those serotonin levels to a level of fluctuation which would be typical for a normal person. So therefore it's not doing anything that wouldn't happen for a normal person anyway, and everybody's levels are different. So there's nothing that directly conflicts with the essential oils in that sense. But yeah, definitely, especially if you're starting out on a medication, you definitely want to be working with your doctor or your psychologist or psychiatrist to make sure that, you know, the effects that they're tracking for the medication aren't going to be conflicting with any effects from the oils and things like that. But yeah, there's nothing about it that is directly conflicting,
yes,
if that makes sense.
But again, as always, talk with your healthcare,
check with your doctor
and go through them as well. Now, Ez is sharing about Citrus Bliss Lemon and Red Mandarin makes you happy every time, which is good to hear because we will be chatting about lemon in just a second as well. And looks like you guys are using your wild orange in your cooking as well, and in your diffuser jewelry. So these are all great uses, and like it's such a versatile oil, which is what I wanted you guys to understand as well with that one. Now, as Erin mentioned, lemon is another uplifting oil. It's a beautiful one for uplifting, joyful. I actually call this oil sunshine in a bottle because I have, every time I'm at a class and I pass this one around, everyone smiles. Like, you can't not smile when you smell it. It's just so happy. It just smells like sunshine and happiness and freshness. So, you know, if you're feeling flat and tired, this is a great oil to pop in the diffuser and just bring that little burst of sunshine to you. This is also a really good one to pop in your water as well, and you can drink throughout the day because it can help with cleansing out your system as well. And it just tastes amazing. It's one I use every morning. Now, another one I'll mention is three of the blends. So doTERRA has, besides their single oils like your lavender, your lemon, your peppermint, they also have formulated some special blends based on the chemical constituents of the oils that work well together to create a certain effect. So three of the ones I'm going to mention is, first of all, Cheer. Then I'm going to talk about our Motivate and our Elevation. So Cheer is the uplifting blend, and it's exactly like the name says. It's cheerful. It's really, really uplifting. It was actually designed to counteract negative emotions by promoting feelings of optimism. It comes as an oil, as I said, and it also comes as a touch roller. So it's one that's a really handy one to keep in your handbag, and you can roll it on you throughout the day when you're feeling upset. It's very citrusy. It's a bit sweet. It's a bit vanilla-y, and it's just a really nice one at helping you feel nice and happy as well. Now, the next one I'll talk about is Motivate. And like the name says, it's a motivating blend. It's a combination of your mints and your citruses. So again, it's going to give that burst of energy and help you to get really invigorated and excited. And it's one that you would use if you're having a day where maybe you had to face a task you weren't really feeling that excited about.
Yeah, something that you can't put off and you got to get done.
Yeah, so it's a good one for that. And this is actually my dad's favorite one. I made him a little roller of it.
It's good for procrastinators.
Yes, really good for procrastinators if you need to clean your house. And again, this one also comes as a touch version. So, you know, if you're at work and you're feeling a bit like, oh God, what am I going to do? Just roll some of that Motivate on your wrist. It's a really quick and easy way you can be using your oils. And the third one I'm going to mention is Elevation, which is the Joyful Blend. Again, it's a really citrusy one. I would say the biggest difference between Cheer and Elevation is Cheer is a bit sweeter because it does have that vanilla, whereas Elevation I find is that little bit, it sounds like I'm describing wines, but it's drier. It doesn't have that sweetness. But this is another oil that I absolutely love using. And I will also mention, so Lavender Peace, Balance, Elevation, and another oil which is called Citrus Bliss. Those four oils together are called the Mood Management Kit. And this is a really great kit if you're wanting to learn about using your oils to support your emotions. You can get them as a little pack of the four. And for those who have a doTERRA account, it's, I think, $124. So if you're maybe thinking of some oils that would be good to add to your wish list, that's a definite kit I would mention as being a good one to think about. Now, Beth has just shared that Motivate was the first blend she bought, and it's still her favorite. And she hasn't met a person yet who doesn't love it, which is very true. I have to say that's true. Michelle loves her Elevation. And Amanda loves her Cheer Touch, which is good to hear because it's such an easy one to be using. Now, the final thing that I will mention, and you guys know I mention this in most of my videos, but it's the Lifelong Vitality Pack. And the reason I mention this is looking after yourself physically, having the correct nutrients in your body is going to obviously help with the way you're feeling overall. And the analogy that I give is, imagine you're a plant. This is going to fertilize your soil, and then the oils are going to work better. And it's just going to help to have your body have that fertile ground so the oils can work at their optimum and ability. It's a combination of three different pills. It is Therapeutic Goods Association approved. It is TGA approved. And it is just an amazing addition to, I guess, your daily lifestyle habits to be using. And we've been on it for since about January, I think. Yeah. And the other thing as well with this is a full dose is a month. It's one pack is a month, but you can split it with someone and just do a half dose and still find it quite beneficial. Now, some other things I will mention as well is there's a couple of other things I'm just going to briefly mention because I am being mindful of the time. Obviously, sleep. Sleep can be a big issue for people with anxiety. I'm not going to go into that in a great detail because sleep is such a big topic. If you guys would like to see me do a talk on sleep, please do pop in the comments. And if I get enough interest, I'll happily do a webinar talking about sleep. But that's where using things like your lavender and your lavender peace can be really beneficial. And even your lavender, your frankincense, and your wild orange. I call that peace and joy. It's a beautiful, beautiful blend you can be using. Another thing I'll mention is drugs and alcohol can often be used as a coping mechanism, but they then create even further issues. So where possible, please do try and avoid it. Now, Bianca has asked a really great question, and that's a really good one, is are there any oils you would stay away from to not increase anxious feelings? When there, oftentimes people can have an emotional reaction to an oil. So they might smell an oil and just instantly hate it. So I've shared a few times, fennel. I cannot stand fennel. I swear, I had to use it once and I nearly vomited. I just, looking at the emotional side of it, there is a very clear reason. And I know exactly why I have an issue with fennel, and it's my own personal issue and I'm working on it. But what I would suggest is if you do have a really intense reaction to an oil to the point where you physically feel ill, just stop, look at it, maybe look at the emotions book, maybe try to figure out what it could be that's triggering you, and then very carefully approach that oil. I can't tell you which one it's going to be for you because it could be something very, very different for each person. And as a general rule, I will say though, for people who have really bad nightmares, vetiver can actually make them worse. And also, interestingly enough, some people do have a reaction to lavender. And for some people, while 99% of the population, lavender is really calming, for some people, they do find lavender can be a bit overwhelming. In which case, I would say try a different floral like your ylang ylang, your geranium, or even your lavender peace. You might be perfectly fine with lavender peace. But again, everyone is different. So it is a bit of a trial and error to figure out what's going to work best for you. The book I'm talking about is called, can you just reach down in there and grab, it's the Emotions and Essential Oil book. Yep, to the that's the one. All right. So this is the older version. This is the old cover, but it's called Emotions and Essential Oils. I do actually have these in stock. If you are a member of my team, if you're enrolled under me, they are $25 each. If you're not, they are $27 plus shipping, or you can pick them up for me directly. If you want to get one of these books, send me a message and we can have a chat about it. But it does go through the emotions behind each of the oils. So if you are finding you're having a really like intense reaction to an oil, great one to have a look at and figure out what might be triggering that. Now, Haley did ask, is there a weight loss oil? Smart and Sassy is the metabolic blend, and that's a really good one to support you if you're looking at, I guess, trying to support your weight loss. That's a really great oil. What's I would suggest.
What's the one for cravings?
Grapefruit. Well.
Grapefruit.
Grapefruit's a really good one for cravings too, and that's in the Smart and Sassy blend. So back to things we can do as well, avoiding drugs and alcohol. Another thing as well is attitude. There's a lot of mind work you can be doing. You've got things like EFT, the tapping, affirmations, prayer, meditation, even mental tricks. Like there's one that I taught Will, which is basically if you're feeling anxious, picture a horse, picture a brown horse, then close your eyes and imagine it's a white horse. And then wait a minute and imagine it's a pink horse and keep changing the color of the horse. And it sounds very strange, but what you're doing is when you're picturing the horse, you're activating the left side of your brain because you're thinking anatomically, what does a horse look like, an actual live creature? But then when you're making it change color, you're activating the right-hand side of your brain, which is your creativity. And by activating both sides at the same time, you're basically stopping that negative cycle of thoughts that you're having at the moment and can kind of break that chain. So that's just one of many, many tricks. And again, seek professional help if that's something you need. Now, Esme has said juniper berry can be a very overwhelming one as well. And that's true. It is quite a strong oil and some people can react to that one too. That said, I find juniper berry can also be quite helpful if you are experiencing bad dreams at night. So again, everyone can be quite unique. Emma has said that's the reaction to Arbor Vitae, which is funny because Arbor Vitae I'm addicted to. So again, it does depend on everyone can be a bit different. And then another factor as well that can impact upon anxiety is physical health. So things like your diet, exercising, you know, there's so much research about getting those natural endorphin boosters, doing exercise, going for walks, getting out in the sunshine. And sometimes, you know, when you're feeling anxious, leaving the house can be a big deal. And I know when I had postnatal depression, I didn't want to leave the house. It was so stressful. But when I would leave, I would feel a bit better.
Yeah, I think one of the biggest general triggers for anxiety is being physically tired but not mentally tired.
Yes.
And just laying in bed thinking, and you know, spending too much time alone with your own thoughts is a really big problem for a lot of people. You know, you go over things over and over and over, you blow things out of proportion in your mind, And
your worst case scenario, everything.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. So things that are really small end up being massive in your head.
Yep.
And to you, that's the reality. To everybody else, it's like, why are you so worried about that?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I will share a story for my dear husband, sending him to do the shopping, to do the grocery shopping. Pretty much when we were first married, it was actually almost the end of our marriage, because I would be like, can you just run to the shops and just grab me some milk and bread? And like an apple. And he would be at the shops going, oh my God, she wants an apple. What kind of apple? What color? And he would literally call me like, I can't find the apple. Which apple do I get? How many do I get? I'm like, just grab apples. Yeah. And so to me, it's like the simplest thing ever. But especially when we moved house and we had a new grocery store.
I don't know where anything is.
I can't find it. And like, I get these panicked phone calls from the grocery store. And so I love you dearly. But then it's about coming up with coping mechanisms. So if I'm going to send him to the grocery store, he has a very detailed list of, I want 5 red apples. I want 6 small cucumbers, very step by step.
There's no room for variation.
No, I have to be very specific.
Ambiguity.
Yeah. And that's the thing. It's about finding what's going to work for you and what's going to help you in your situation, which again can be quite different. Now, there was a question, Barbara, the name of the kit that I was talking about is called the Mood Management Kit. So it's your Balance, your Lavender Peace, your Citrus Bliss, and your Elevation as well. For those that are struggling with Digestin, I could see a few of you saying that. Digestin has fennel in it. So as you can imagine, my reaction, it's like, what's going to make me feel worse? If I don't take the Digestin and I'll still feel sick, or I do take the Digestin and I have to deal with the fennel, I usually have to weigh up how bad I feel, but Digestin is still quite a beneficial oil. And look, if you are struggling with if you are struggling with that particular oil, I would suggest putting it on the bottom of your feet, or even popping it into a veggie cap like that, then you just swallow it. You don't have to smell the taste of it. Okay, so what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna finish up quickly. Now, it appears that our preschooler has climbed out of bed, so my husband may need to duck off.
I might need to duck off
and go into daddy duty, but we'll see how we go. If you do have any last questions, please do type them in now, because we are just gonna start finishing up. I just want to let you know, first of all, thank you guys for watching. Now, if you've been watching and you'd really love to find out about how you can get some of these beautiful oils, the best way to take advantage of these oils is to get your own account with doTERRA. So what that means is when you have your own account, you get an automatic 25% discount off full price. You have your own online shopping cart and you can log in whenever you want and it just gets shipped straight to your door. You don't have to pick stuff off of me. It doesn't matter where in the world you're located. We can get these oils to you. Now, in terms of how to get access to get your own account, there's 2 ways. The first way is you pay a $35 membership fee, and then you can just pick and choose whatever products you want to get. The second way is you can get a starter kit. Now, there are a few different starter kits, and if you want to have a chat about which one's going to be best for you, certainly send me a message, or you can jump onto my website, www.lavenderandfriends.com, and I do go through the enrollment kits there as well. I also did a video a couple of nights ago about, you know, you want to start getting oils, what ones to get. If you watch that, I go through the kits in more detail, but I will very quickly just mention two of the kits that I love. The first one is our Natural Solutions Kit. Now, this is a really great kit. If you are serious about making over your home and lifestyle, this is a great one to get started with. It's got the top 10 oils. It's got a lot of oils that we talked about today. So you've got your lavender peace, your lavender. It's got your frankincense. It's got your diffuser and your fractionated coconut oil. It's got your Clary Calm, which is a women's monthly blend, and Past Tense, which is a relaxation blend. And it's basically a really great kit to get started and get you going with everything you need. Now, if you did want to purchase this kit today, I do have a very special gift for you. And if you send me a message, I can have a bit of a chat about that, what it can be. Now, the other 2 kits I'm going to briefly mention is our Home Essentials Kit and our Family Essentials Kit. Now, these are our 2 most popular oils, or oil kits to get started with. So the big difference is our Home Essentials Kit comes with a diffuser, and it also has the 15ml big bottles. The Family Essentials Kit does not have a diffuser. It has a Smart and Sassy, and it has 5ml bottles. So for around $150 more, you will get a diffuser plus 3 times as much oil. That said, whatever your budget is, if you only have the budget for 5ml, I'd rather you had 5ml of oil than none at all. Both of these kits do contain some of the oils we talked about tonight, like our frankincense, our lavender, those beautiful oils. And again, I do have a lovely gift for those who want to take advantage of that. So please do send me a message and we can get you started. once you, it's pretty easy to get started. Basically, we'll just have a chat. I'll get some personal details off you and pop that enrollment through. And then we'll book in for your wellness consult. So the wellness consult is about, takes about 45 minutes to an hour. We can do it online via Zoom, or we can meet up local to me in around the Central Coast. And basically, we'll just go through what oils you've got, how to use them, how to get the most out of your account. We'll make up a roller together. If you've purchased a kit, you'll get a beautiful piece of diffuser jewelry as a thank you. And it's just a chance for you to get really confident in using those oils. As I said, the other option is you could pay the $35 membership fee and then just pick and choose. Maybe you really like the sound of a diffuser and that mood management kit and you want to get started with that. Whatever it is, we can have a chat about what you think is going to work best for you. So I'm actually going to be online for the next hour or so. So feel free to send me any messages and we can have a bit of a chat about what's going to work best for you. And I'll just see if there's any other extra questions. Let's see. Lots of thank yous, and thank you guys for joining us as well. And now Rebecca says Digest Zen brings back the Sambuca days, and yes, that's very, very true. Now Michelle, are existing members allowed to get the Home Essentials kit? Yes, you can. You can purchase a kit if you want to. Now the advantage of the kit is when you purchase the kit, you don't pay the $35 to get a membership account. That comes free with the kit. So one thing I will mention, which I didn't before, is that if you purchase the kit, you can add anything you want to that kit. So, and you'll be paying the member's price, which is that 25% discount. So maybe you want to get a Home Essentials kit and you'd like to add a bottle of fractionated coconut oil so you can start using those oils topically. You can add that to that initial enrollment order and that's completely fine. So that's all for me. If you guys don't have any other questions for Will and I, thank you so much to Will for joining me and for, I guess, opening up his heart and sharing about his experiences, because it is, like we both said, it's important to be having this conversation and talking about mental health and raising awareness, and also raising awareness of what we can do to support in a natural way. The other thing I'll finish with is if you'd like more information, you can always visit my website, which is www.lavenderandfriends.com. And I also have a Facebook group, which is called the Lavender and Friends Oil Squad. Now it's open to anyone. So if you'd like to learn more about oils, it's a great place to jump in. Or if you've already got oils and just want some more education and inspiration, again, feel free to jump in and join us. That's all for now. Next week at 7 p.m., we will be doing a webinar on calm kids. And we'll be chatting about how we can use our oils to create a beautiful, calm environment for our kids and also for ourselves as well. So without further ado, I hope you guys have had a lovely evening, and chat to you later. Cheers.